Morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. If you're in the central Wisconsin area or really anywhere in the state, probably experienced a little bit of snow this morning. And it's kind of the first time this winter that that stuff's really accumulating. So winter is finally here. And we've been going through, we started yesterday the Ten Commandments. And we're going to go through these Ten Commandments both this week and next week. So, of course, yesterday we started with the first commandment. And in that first commandment, you shall have no other gods. It's when we look at all the rest of the commandments, they are an extension of the first. Okay. When you break 2 through 10, excuse me, you're also breaking the first. Okay. And so that commandments 2 through 10 really just go into more detail on how different ways that we have other gods. Because to someone who's never heard that before and is a Christian, says you shall have no other gods, well, yeah, of course, God's my God. And then you realize that when you take the Lord's name in vain, when you covet things, when you steal, etc., you are having other gods. So very interesting when we look at the Ten Commandments that way. So let us know how you're doing this morning. I see some people joining, and we'll get started. So what is the second commandment? We also talked yesterday about how there are some churches who split the first commandment into two, and there's some who split the last into two, and we would fall into that category. Okay, so that's why the second commandment is, you shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God. What does this mean? Okay, this is from Luther's Small Catechism, and we've read this before in church. What does this mean? We should fear and love God so that we do not curse, swear, use satanic arts, lie, or deceive by his name, but call upon it in every trouble, pray, praise, and give thanks. So there's really more depth to this commandment than just don't say, gee damn, when you stub your toe. Okay, there's more to this than that. This is making sure that we don't curse and swear, yes, but also that we don't misuse God's name, as it says, for satanic arts or for some kind of sorcery, okay? Maybe we don't think of using God's name in sorcery, but if we're trying to manipulate God's name to get something that we want, that would fall under that category, okay? Lie or deceive by his name. That's also how you misuse the name of the Lord your God. So sometimes Christians will say, well, this needs to happen because God told me to do this, or God told me this is what's going to happen. Well, that's oftentimes, when it's not genuine, misusing the name of the Lord and deceiving people, and it's breaking the second commandment, okay? So this is a very important commandment for us, isn't it? The central thought here is when we trust God with our hearts, we use our lips to call upon him as our creator and our redeemer. And so God does want us to use his name, okay? That's why he's revealed it to us. He wants us to use his name to call upon him when we are in times of trouble, to also give thanks to him, to pray continually, to praise his name, okay? So we are to use God's name. And really, when we're using his name properly, it's a heart check that our heart's in the right spot. If we start misusing God's name, it's a good indicator that we've drifted from him. And we first need to search our hearts and see where we've drifted, how we can confess and find forgiveness and draw near to him again. And then out from your lips will flow praises to God instead of curses, etc. Okay, so it's really a reflection of the heart is what comes out of our mouth with the name of God. In the Old Testament, God reveals his personal name, Yahweh, which means I am. Okay, in the New Testament, God reveals himself through Jesus. What does Jesus's name mean? Yahweh saves. Okay, so when Christians confess Jesus is Lord, it means Jesus is Yahweh in human flesh. Okay, he is God who has taken on that name of God, Yahweh, in the human flesh. So why did God reveal his name to us? So that we might know who created and redeemed us. It's kind of nice, right? To know who created us, where we came from, and to call upon him on a personal level. He wants to know us on a personal level as children call on their father, right? Just as when I get home, my son runs up, he says, "Daddy." Okay, that's a personal greeting. And that's the way that God wants us to have a relationship with him, is to be that personal as well. He also reveals his name so we can proclaim it to all people, okay? And so we can praise his name, so we can make his name great through the way we live our lives. So how do we break the second commandment? We talked about it. Not using his name in vain, not swearing with his name, not to manipulate God for our purposes in sorcery or magic. And that can be just to say, use God's name in the name of Jesus, you know, my finances be multiplied. Okay, that's using God's name for sorcery. Also not to deceive others by speaking falsely about God. It's very important when we use God's name, it's a responsibility, isn't it? That's what the second commandment is teaching us. So how do we keep this commandment? We use his name to seek from him all good things for ourselves and others. We call upon him in times of trouble. We acknowledge in thanks and praise that all good things have come from him alone. So anytime you are blessed, you have an opportunity to praise his name and make his name great. And we also keep this commandment by speaking and teaching truthfully about God in accordance with his word. He's given us his name. He's given us his word. We have a responsibility to represent him properly. So how is God's name used today? It's kind of a reflection of our culture and where God is at in the hearts of our culture overall, right? Because in our culture, sometimes God is our buddy who helps us in times of trouble, but more just there as a resource. Sometimes in our culture, God is mocked, right? God's name is used in vain freely in our culture, even in humor, okay? And it's a reflection of the heart that we're far from him in many ways. So I want to read you an example of someone in scripture who praised God's name. And this is from Luke 1, 39 to 56. And this is from the Christmas gospel. And it says, "In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a town in Judah. And she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth." So this is after Mary finds out that she's pregnant. She goes to visit her cousin Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. And she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted to me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord." And then Mary says, and she releases this song of praise that she just can't contain. It's called the Magnificat. She says, "My soul magnifies the Lord." The Lord is Yahweh. That's his name. "And my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and returned to her home. Wow, that's praising God's name, isn't it? That's praising God's name. What inspired Mary to praise God's name? Well, first she had faith, right? She had faith. She knew God. You can't praise God's name if you don't know him, right? If you don't know enough about him to praise him. So that's first and foremost. Mary's praising God's name because she is blessed. She's blessed to be the mother of our Lord, but she's also blessed to have her cousin be this excited about her, because for Mary, she's also a social outcast in some ways because she's pregnant out of wedlock. And so Elizabeth's joy for her then makes Mary burst into this song of joy, okay? And so all of these things cause Mary to praise God's name. Now, notice her lens also causes her to praise God's name, because being pregnant out of wedlock for some people, obviously, is not seen as a blessing, okay? And this is a very different circumstance for Mary. We know that, okay? She's pregnant by the Holy Spirit. But she could have also been feeling sorry for herself that all of these people were looking at her like an outcast. But she is using the lens of blessing, and she is giving praise to the Lord. So our application for today is, how can you show that God is your creator and your redeemer by the way you speak in your daily conversations with others? Okay, how can you glorify God? How can you honor the second commandment in the way that you speak, not just about him, but in your daily conversations with others, and then the way that you see your life, okay? Let's pray. Jesus, thank you for your commandments. Though they are law, they are blessing. And we are blessed when we follow them. We are blessed when we obey them, Lord. Help us to remember that when our mouths don't honor you, they are a reflection of the heart, and then help us to turn our hearts back to you. Let that be a sign to us, Lord, when our mouths don't honor you, that we need to run to your throne. And so, Lord, I pray that each one of us, you would strengthen, you would bless, to bless your name and to bless it freely without reserve. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. God's blessings, everybody. Drive safe out there. Happy Tuesday. We'll see you again tomorrow morning for the third commandment. Take care.